There are decisions you should make. It determines whether you are a star or a dust. A dust is tossed to and fro. A star doesn't change its position. A dust is at the mercy of the wind. If the wind is going easterly, the dust is driving towards that side. A dust can be here, you meet it tomorrow. That's the dust. He has no place called his own. Glory to God. Are you a dust or a star? A star. Who is a star? A star is the one who stands on his word until he sees answer. A star is here, but it's not shining because it is still afternoon. But when night comes, it shines. It's still there. If you're dust, this is what happened to you. And he said, who told thee that thou art naked? Those of you yesterday, you remember this story? Who told you that you are naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree? God is asking Adam, have you eaten of the tree? Because you are telling me you're naked. How come you know you're naked? Have you eaten of the tree? God was giving Adam another chance to baffle the devil. The things of God are lies to men. God knows Adam ate. He knows Adam ate. But he never wanted Jesus to die. He never wanted to drive man from Eden. He has foreseen suffering and then posed a question that if Adam would have said, I have not eaten life until now. He said, I'm now eating of the fruit that I said you should not eat. Verse 12. Verse 12, sir. And the man said, this is not what God wants to hear. Man. Oh, the man said, the woman whom you gave me to be with me, she gave me. God is trying to take the blame out of him. He is trying to put the blame on God. You understand? God is struggling to let him not accept that he has done it. He is struggling also to put the blame on God. Is the woman which you gave me to be with me? I never asked you. I was fine in the garden you made wife. She gave me of the tree and I did eat. Oh, that's that statement, and I did eat. A man is not condemned by what he ate. Now, not what goes into, that's what the Bible says. Not what goes into a mouth defies a man, but what comes out of it. So when Adam ate, nothing has happened. But when Adam said, I did, everything spoiled. So God came and spoke. God knows the action has been done, but I want to hear what he will say. For that, by your words, you are condemned. By your words, you are just if I... Adam could have said, I didn't eat it, for I know who I am. God could have said, I know you, boy. When Satan came to Job, he took everything. The wife came and said, I understand that you can't die once you have not cursed God. Curse God and die. So she combined the two. It's a setup. It's a formula. Once you curse, you die. It is your prayer of faith
that heals, not the prayer of days. Did you get that? Giving will become a delight if your life is a gift. If your life becomes a gift, giving will become a delight. Hallelujah. Is your life a gift? Paul says, I beseech you, brethren, you present yourself, right? Present yourself. I want to teach you something I titled The Stars and the Dust. Some of you may remember this message. We need it on CD. Glory to God. The Stars and the Dust. Are you a star? Or are you a dust? Star, right? The stars and the dust. Genesis chapter 2, verse 5. The dust and the stars. The stars and the dust. And every plant of the field before it was in the earth, and every herb of the field before it grew up. For the Lord God had not caused it to rain upon the earth. And there was not a man to till the ground. There was not a man to till the ground. Verse 6. But there went up a mist from the earth, and it watered the whole face of the ground. And the Lord God formed man out of the dust. God formed man out of the dust. Did you notice he made dust? And he formed man out of the dust. Very bad. And breath into his nostrils. The breath of life. So this is two now. The natural man of the dust and the one with the breath of life. And this man now became a living soul. So the only way you can be a soul, a living soul, is when you have breath of life. Take note, he formed man out of the dust of the earth. Out of the dust of the earth. And man became a living soul. What did he use to form man? The dust. The dust. So we want to understand what's the meaning of the stars and the dust. In the Christendom, in the Christian race, what is star and dust? Who am I? Am I a star or am I a dust? I'm going to show you now. Then you shall know if you're a star or a dust. Praise the Lord. Am I a star or am I a dust? And if you're a star, what are the things you experience? And if you're a dust, what are the predicaments you'll be facing? So you see now, some of the things you are facing will help you differentiate where you are. If you're a star or a dust. Praise the Lord Jesus. Genesis chapter 13. Verse 15. For all the land which thou seest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed forever. And I will make thy seed as what? The dust of the earth. So that if a man can number the dust of the earth, then thy seed shall also be numbered. But there's a comparison here. He said, I will make thy seed as the dust. Before giving a numeric importance, he said, I will make thy seed as the dust. I will be to some a stumbling block. I will make thy seed dust.
Christianity is a life that you should prepare before you start the race. It's not a cheap life you enter and come out. You enter again and you come out. You leave church, you come back, you leave church again. You are making a caricature with the devil and he would go after you. The first day I received Christ, 14 December 2004, 9 p.m. After I received Christ, the meeting closed. I didn't go home. I was moving along a school, a primary school, they call GPS. And I spoke to God that I will never go back. And I receiving Christ doesn't mean I was a typical sinner. I was a sinner, yes, because if you don't have Christ, what are you, a virgin? You're a sinner. Did you get that? A virgin without Christ is a sinful virgin. So I was not going to clubs. I was not in those things. But I was not born again. So when I became born again, I told God, I will never, whether I hear that you don't exist. Until one night I made God a statement. I said, if you appear to me and said there is no God, then you appear late. There are words I've spoken to God that I can't see myself falter. I spoke to God that as I live, I will never abuse any man of God. 2007, December 11th, I will never forget. December 11th, I said, as I live, I will never, until then. Then the devil stirred up all kinds of issues where I was worshiping. I was abused by figure, by picture, by message, by any stuff, by physicality. And I keep remembering what I said 2007. 11 December. Devil, shoot your words. You can't change my decision. People started leaving church because they were maltreating me. I said, devil, I can't speak a word. There are decisions you should make. It determines whether you are a star or a dust. A dust is tossed to and fro. A star doesn't change its position. A dust is at the mercy of the wind. If the wind is going easterly, the dust is driving towards that side. A dust can be here, you meet it tomorrow. As fan blows, he's in Arise and Shine. Fan blows, he's in King David Church. King David. That's the dust. He has no place called his own. Some group of people, God's own chosen people, wanted to take over a land. They sent 12 people to go and check if they can take. The people went and said, no, we can't take this land. The people we saw, we are like grasshoppers in their eyes. He sent 2 people to go and check later. The 2 people went and said, we will take over the land. 2 different persons. Same view. Are you a star or a dust? It's not by words. It's by following the message. By the end, you will know you have been a moving worshiper as a dust. Glory to God. Are you a dust or a star? You're a star. Who is a star? A star is the one who stands on his word until he sees answer. A star is here, but it's not shining. Because it is still afternoon. But when night comes, it shines. He's still there. How long have you been in LTM? 2 months. By the next 2 months, we're not seeing you again. A sandpit. Those who came in for the first time, let me see you. Next 2 weeks, they thought they have had a member. You're in Kasala. If you're here for your first time, let me see your hand. Dust of the earth. You are carried to and fro. The Bible says, don't be carried to and fro by every wind of doctrine. It means if you are not carried by every wind of doctrine, you're a star. You hold on to the one God has given you. When Paul came back to the Corinth, he said, who has given you another gospel? gospel. Who bewitched you with another gospel? He spoke that to the Corinthians, spoke that to the Galatians. Who gave you another gospel from that which I have given you? He said, hold on to the sure word of prophecy till the day star arises. That means what God has said to me and the light to my world, no matter the darkness I see, I hold it till I testify. Some are sitting here now with passport in their pocket. They have given themselves 2 weeks. This is the second week. Sunday is the last attempt. Are you here? Now, I need to tell you plain truth. Be a star. Be a star. Say amen. I will make that seed as the dust. Imagine this is God talking. I'll make thy seed as the dust. God forbid for me seeing myself as a dust. Glory to God. Let's see again. God re-echoed that in Genesis 28 verse 11. Genesis 28 11. And he lighted up a certain place and tarried there all night because the sun was set. And he took the stones of that place and put them for his pillows and laid down in that place to sleep. His pillow was stones. That man's head was rock. Verse 12. And he dreamt, and behold, a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached where? To heaven. And behold, the angels of God ascending. I've taught you that, right? Ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, thy father, and the God of Isaac. The land whereon thou liest, to thee will I give it. And to thy seed, what a promise, I will give it to you and your seed. And thy seed shall be as the dust of the earth. And thou shalt spread abroad to the west, to the east, to the north, and to the south. And in thee and in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. As the dust. If you are a dust, let me show what will happen to you. Are you here? Genesis chapter 3, verse 11. If you're dust, this is what will happen to you. And he said, who told thee that thou art naked? Those of you yesterday, you remember this story? Who told you that you are naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree? But don't they say God knows everything? He's omniscience now. All knowing. God, you know all things. Why are you asking Adam if he has eaten? You ought to have seen it. Were you sleeping? Haven't this crossed your mind? Is it an important question? God is asking Adam, have you eaten of the tree? Because you are telling me you're naked. How come you know you're naked? Have you eaten of the tree? God, I know God like. Like rice and stew, you know. I know God. I understand God. God was giving Adam another chance to baffle the devil. God was giving Adam another chance to lie. The things of God are lieness to men. God knows Adam ate. He knows Adam ate. But he never wanted Jesus to die. He never wanted to drive man from Eden. He has foreseen suffering and then posed a question that if Adam could have said, I have not eaten, life continues. He said, have thou eaten of the food that I said you should not eat? Verse 12. And the man said, this is not what God wants to hear. Man. all, the man said, the woman whom you gave me to be with me, she gave. God is trying to take the blame out of him. He is trying to put the blame on God. You understand? God is struggling to let him not accept that he has done it. He is struggling also to put a blame on God. Is the woman which you gave me to be with me? I never asked you. I was fine in the garden you made wife. She gave me of the tree and I did it. Oh, that's that statement, and I did it. A man is not condemned by what he ate. Now, not what goes into, that's what the Bible says. Not what goes into a mouth defies a man, but what comes out of it. So, when Adam ate, nothing has happened. But when Adam said, I did, everything spoiled. So, God came and spoke. God knows the action has been done. But I want to hear what he will say. For that, by your words, you are condemned. By your words, you are just if I'd. Adam could have said, I didn't eat it, for I know who I am. God could have said, I know you, boy.
Stay tuned. Apostle Divine will be right back.
To get a full copy of this message, call us on these numbers. +237 652 848 668. 6788-673-66.
Or email at transformerstv@yahoo.com.
Apostle Divine Co. Kefor.
Major.